I'm Gabrielle E. Wilks, a senior biology and mathematics major from Brooklyn, New York, but I currently reside in Douglasville, Georgia. I attend the Virginia State University, and I hail as the current Miss Black Virginia 2020. The fact that my family was able to come to a completely different country with completely different standards, ethics, and morals, and still end up on top. Like, it's a pride kind of thing. Like, you really left everything behind to come to a new area, a new place to create a better life for the people that come after you. Like, that's so selfless. And I'm prideful in the fact that, you know, like, my grandfather and my ancestors had that love for me, and they had that faith to know that I would be something greater than what they were, that they wanted to give me the chance to have a better opportunity at becoming a better me. For HBCUs, like, the queen of the university, like, those pageants are always, like, you'll see campaign season, these people go all out. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I was definitely feeling anxious, especially because I knew how many people knew how much I wanted it, like, so, yeah, but in terms of checking off boxes, I don't believe so, because my university, the people around me have accepted me as I was. Like, they knew who I was even before I ran. So, like, I didn't feel the need to, you know, be somebody else for the people. So, yeah, so I ran for Miss Virginia State University, and I got first runner-up.
Okay.
Yeah, so that was what the voting was for. And then after I got first runner-up, I went on, and then one of the pageant judges actually recommended to the pageant coach for me to enter into the Miss Black USA pageant system. Wow. It was like the light at the end of the tunnel. Like, my junior year, I went through a lot, like, emotionally and academically, you know, not knowing, like, what I wanted to do after college and all that. So it was a lot, like, of pressure, I want to say. And being that it was at the end of the school year, I was just like, all right, I'm just going to do it. Like, I was at the point where I'm just going to do it, whatever. And it was, like, finally a win. Like, you know how it's, like, a rainbow after all that rain and all those storms and stuff? Like, and to win that, it was just, like, you know, it taught me a lesson for myself. Like, you just have to keep going. Like, one of the biggest things for me is prostate cancer awareness. Okay. Because my grandfather, he died from prostate cancer awareness. And yeah, thank you. But even though, you know, even though he went to the doctor and he got his information, like, it's, you know, it's hard not to think, like, what would have happened had we been more aware. And you know how Jay-Z, like, pushed forward this generational wealth thing?
Right.
So I turned it into being generational health. Mm-hmm. Because a lot of times, like, for some reason, we don't associate health with wealth, and it helps with the confirmation of what I feel my purpose is. Every time that I've tried to stray away from medicine, like, there's always something or always somebody that I meet, and it just gives me hope to, you know, continue.
She's always looking ahead, and it's not because she's my daughter. I'm just saying, even if you go back to her school, they'll tell you, oh, Gabrielle, born grown. She was always grown. You know, she's super. It's good to end with the scripture that you like so much, which is Jeremiah 29, verse 11, that God knows the plan he has for each and every one of us. And I believe it's important for each person to have that life verse, you know. And this is the plan I believe God has for her, you know, to walk this path to get her to where he wants her to be. Mm-hmm. So it's good to have that solid faith and to know that God doesn't make any mistake.